This is a video about the number 506, its relevance to Thelema and how it may be a secret key to Aleister Crowleys Liber via Legis. If you want to shun discussions about the contents of Liber, you may turn this clip off now. First, let's look at the relations between the numbers 506 and 11. 11 is an important number in Thelema. It represents the unification of the microcosmos 5 and the macrocosmos 6. The ALW cipher used in Nuyen English Kabbalah is based on an 11-edged star. My number is 11, as all their numbers four of us. In mathematics, the digit sum of a given integer is the sum of all its digits. The digit sum of 506 is 11. 5 plus 0 plus 6 equals 11. 506 is also the 11th 11-gonal number. In mathematics, the polygonal number is a number represented as dots arranged in the shape of a regular polygon. The first 11 hemidecagonal numbers are 1, 11, 30, 58, 95, 141, 196, 260, 333, 415 and 506. 506 is also the 11th square pyramidal number. In mathematics, the square pyramidal number is a figure 8 number that represents the number of stacked spheres in a pyramid with a square base. The first 11 square pyramidal number are 1, 5, 14, 30, 55, 91, 140, 204, 285, 385 and 506. Now, let's have a look at how the number 56 is related to the goddess Nuit. I am Nuit, and my word is 6 and 50. This relates to the first two and principal letters in the name Nuit. Then, Nun, equals 50 and U, Vod, equals 6. In Gematria, there is a method named the sparkaton that calculates the value of each letter, but truncates all of zeros. Then 50 is 5 plus U 6 equals 11. And note, if aught can be so ordered in the kingdom, the 3 or more is 0, as well as older truths. Liber penny per numbra. Liber all via Legis also identifies the goddess Nuit with nothing, or in mathematical terms, 0. 56 equals 0. Nothing is a secret key of this law. 61 the Jews call it, I call it 8, 80, 418. Liber all via Legis. 61 may refer to Aine, which is Hebrew for nothing. A1 plus I10 plus and 50 equals 61 equals 0. 8, 80, 418 equals 506. This is probably the most direct reference to the number 506 in Liber via Legis. 8 and AE may refer to the cubes, K20 plus H5 plus A1 plus B2 plus S60 equals 88. 418 is of course the well-known number of the great work. To understand the next relations, we need to add colors to the individual numbers. Let's start with Nu. My color is black to the blind, but the blue and gold are seen of the seeing. Here we have Nuit associated with the color blue and gold. For the sake of simplicity, let's assume that gold and yellow are pretty much interchangeable and stick with yellow. On the steel of revealing, we can see that Nuit wears something like a golden nail at her ankle. In Kabbalistic attributions, a nail relates to the letter Vav. This leaves us with the letter Nun as the blue part. In Kabbalistic attributions, the letter Nun is associated with a fish, therefore ruling the element of water. So we have N50 equals blue, water and V6 equals yellow, air. This attribution is also supported by the Book of the Dead. Hail, thou sycamore tree of the goddess Nut. Give me of the water and of the air which is in thee. This comprises pretty much the first part of the puzzle as covered in Chapter 1 of Liber alvio Legis. For the second part, we have to take Hadit into the picture, for I am perfect, being not, and my number is 9 by the fools. Here we have had it associated with the number 9. As we did with knew it, let's forget about the and stick with the head. In gematria we have head equals 5, odd left equals 1, and odd left equals 4. By the fools may give us a hint to also forget about the A for now. In tarot, the fool is associated with the letter A left, and has the number 0. So 1 equals A equals 0. Compare the formula IAO, Isis, Apophis, Osiris. Now we have H5 plus A0 plus D4 equals 9 by the fools. Let's have a look at the colors and elements to this. Blue am I and gold in the light of my bride, but the red gleam is in my eyes, and my spangles are purple and green. The first part again associates the blue and gold or yellow with knew it. The second part leaves red, purple and green. Red represents the color of the element fire, green represents the element earth. Purple isn't associated with any element, but is the only thing left. We may associate it with spirit as the fifth element. Or in terms of Liber Legis, purple beyond purple, it is the light higher than eyesight. Ultraviolet. So, let's sum up and add genders to the deities and to the elements. Knew it, female 1050, blue water, female U6, yellow air, male. Have it male H5, red fire, male A1 equals 0. Purple spirit D4, green earth, female. To understand the final conclusion following next, it is important that you were able to follow up so far. If that isn't the case, it is suggested to wind this video back and watch again. Divide, add, multiply, and understand. It's pretty hard to describe this part with words. Instead, I will just show you the formula and leave the final interpretation up to you. You may probably want to hit pause here and meditate on it for a while. Observe how the numbers derived from knew it and had it relate to the aether in a very unique way. And how we can preserve the elements we associated with the numbers. Also how the A can be used as a 1 or a 0. This is the creation of the world, that the pain of division is as nothing, and the joy of dissolution all.